Hello, this is Charlie Rich, and I'd like to welcome you to the Ralph Emery Show, brought to you by Buckwheats.
That's Buckwheats, the breakfast cereal, and of course, Chippo's Potato Chips brings you the show, too.
Thank you, Ralph. Nice to be here.
You bring your piano?
I brought it.
Fine. I don't think we can use it just yet because Buck Owens is going to open the show.
Transistor radio comes from far away, and when it's night over here, over there, it's a breaking day. I remember all the good times I had of walking in the sand with the beautiful girl that I met made in Japan. The beauty of her face was beyond my wildest dreams, like cherry blossoms blooming in the mountain in the early spring. As we walked by the river and she softly took hold of my hand, that's when I fell deep in love with the girl made in Japan. Would lay on Tokyo Bay, and the singing of the birds woke us up at the break of day. Her smiling eyes always seemed to try to understand all the love in my heart for the girl made in Japan. My transistor radio comes from far away, and when it's night over here, over there, it's breaking day. She cried when she said she'd been promised to another man. That's when I left my heart with the girl made in Japan. Yes, my heart will always be with the girl made in Japan.
That's our show opener from Buck Owens, Buck singing Made in Japan. Want to know a good way to get the family tumbling out of bed in the morning and ready for any chores? Then you do like the man says.
Bring on a downright hearty breakfast. Pour out a wholesome bowl of buckwheat. Spoon up a taste like no flakes had before. You get bold, brawny buckwheat together with a light snap of maple. It's the taste you've been missing in high nutrition. Put some buckwheats upon your table.
You'll know what a good idea that is when you try High Nutrition Buckwheats. Imagine a breakfast cereal the taste of buckwheat and maple. That's gotta be the greatest combination of flavors ever. But flavor's only half the story. Buckwheats is one of America's favorite high nutrition cereals. Helps a family feel like a million bucks. So get them up and get them going with Buckwheats.
Put some buckwheats upon your table. Yeah, put some buckwheats upon your table.
Charlie Rich is our guest this week. Charlie, you told me earlier that you took piano lessons from the third grade on through college.
Well, through 1 year in college, and
where'd
then
you
I
went
to service at the University of Arkansas.
I see. You're a Razorback.
I'm a Razorback.
Do you go to the football games and yell like a hog?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we still do that.
What's that yell they have in Arkansas?
Well, it's a little hard for me to do it without a crowd, but it's like, ooh, I can't do it. I'm hoarse. Anyway, it's ooh, pig suey, you know.
Ooh, pig suey.
Ooh, pig suey.
I get the impression from what I read about the University of Arkansas that they would rather beat Texas than anybody else.
That's about the way it is. It's about the way it is.
Are you a big football fan, Charlie?
Yes, I really am.
You
We were talking about the piano. Have you ever thought about putting out since you're in show business, a Charlie Rich piano course?
Yeah, I've thought about it and still plan to do it eventually.
You going to put out a book?
A book?
Well, I know that some courses, like Buck Owens has a guitar course that he teaches on tape, where he tells you what to do. And I wondered if you were going to put it on tape or put it in a book.
I haven't thought that much about that. Probably on tape.
Do you play the piano on your own sessions?
Most of the time. Sometimes, like if we have a thing where I may need to be up by the chorus or something, like some of the guys are feeling, we usually have another piano player on the session, but most of the time I play it.
But when you don't play, what are you doing? Just standing there singing?
Right.
What determines whether you play or not?
I don't really know what determines it. If we feel that it'll help to have another piano player play it, fine.
I see.
Just the overall product.
The feel of the song.
Right.
Here's a nice tune, and a lot of our listeners are housewives. This is a song, I suppose, sort of in defense of the housewife. Or perhaps I should say that the song begs for a little more consideration for the housewife. And it's a beautiful song done by our guest star, Charlie Rich. And if you're a housewife, just listen, and I think you'll see what I mean.
She may get weary. Women do get weary. Wearing the same shabby dress. And when she's weary, try a little tenderness. You know she's waiting, just anticipating things she may never possess. And while she's without them, try a little tenderness. It's not just sentimental. She has her grief and care, and a word that's soft and gentle makes it easier to bear. You won't regret it. Women, don't forget it, 'cause love all so easy. Try a little tenderness. It's all so easy. Try a little tenderness.
Charlie Rich on our show. Charlie, our guest star this week, in that beautiful, beautiful song, Try a Little Tenderness. You like Dolly Parton records?
Yes, I really do.
I thought on this show we'd go back for an oldie. We'll go back, I guess, about a year, perhaps 18 months for this song. And I love to hear Dolly when she does the real driving, up-tempo things. And this is one of her best.
There was this little old rundown shack, and in it lived a man I'd never seen. Folks said he was a mean and a vicious man, and you better not set foot on his land. But I didn't think nobody could be that mean. So I took me out walking down the railroad track. I was gonna go down to that little old shack and just find out if all them things I'd heard was true. There was a big black dog laying out in the yard, and it growled at me, and I swallowed hard, and I heard somebody say, "Well, who are you?" Oh, and there he stood in the door of that shack, and his beard and his hair was long and black, and he was the biggest man I'd ever seen. When he spoke, his voice was low and deep, but he just didn't frighten me, 'cause somehow I just knew he wasn't mean. He said, "What you doing snooping around my place?" And I saw a smile come across his face, so I smiled back and I told him who I was. He said, "Come on in and pull you up a chair. You might as well since you're already here." And he said, "You can call me Joshua. Joshua, Joshua, what you doing living here all alone? Joshua, Joshua, ain't you got nobody to call your own? No, 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 no." We talked till the sun was clean out of sight, and we still talking when it come daylight. There was just so much we had to say. Hey, my life in an orphan's home, and just like him, I was all alone. So I said, "Yeah," when he asked if I'd stay. Well, we grew closer as time went on, and that little old shack, it was a happy home, and we just couldn't help but fall in love. That big black dog and that little old shack, sitting down by the railroad track, it's plenty good enough for me and Joshua. Joshua, Joshua, why you're just what I've been looking for. Joshua, Joshua, you ain't gonna be lonesome anymore. No, no. You're late, oh, late, late. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Me and Joshua. Me and Joshua.
Miss Dolly Parton, Dolly singing about a fellow that she met one day, a fellow named Joshua. You know, you're always going to find some folks who'll resist any kind of progress, who'll take the attitude that what was good enough for Grandpa is plenty good enough for them. And that's too bad in a way, because folks with that attitude might never try Chippos, the new kind of potato chip from Betty Crocker. You didn't know there'd been any progress in potato chips? Well, there sure has. Where ordinary potato chips were made from raw potato slices and were usually greasy, Chippos are made from dried potato granules, and they're flash fried, with the result that they have less oily taste and better flavor. Chippos compare to old-fashioned potato chips like stereo compares to the old wind-up gramophone. And that, my friends, is progress indeed. But the proof, as always, is in the eating. So I sure hope you'll try Chippos today. Chippos, new-fashioned potato chips with less oily taste and better flavor. Now, Charlie, how about introducing the next guest star?
Well, here's an old boy from around my part of the country, Glenn Kendall.
Is he really?
He's from Delight, I think.
Is Delight, Arkansas, close to your part of the country?
It's 50 miles or so, I think. And it's pretty small town, you know. I've just seen the signs pointing there. I've never been in there.
You were about to introduce who?
Mr. Glenn Campbell, singing Manhattan, Kansas.
Manhattan, Kansas, ain't no place to have a baby when you got no man to give it his last name. And her folks back in Manhattan didn't want her or her bundle, so she took her child and caught an evening train. She found a job in Denver, washing dishes in a diner. At least it buys her baby milk to drink. He once told her she was pretty, but the only ring it got her was the ring of grease that runs around the seam. Yes, she lay beside him gentle, 'cause he told her that he loved her, and he made her dance before the music played. But at least she didn't beg him, she'd rather wash her dishes. It makes her feel as if her hands are clean. At night she stands there thinking about the man back home in Kansas, and how her folks just turned away the shame. She stares down through the soap suds, reaches down and pulls the drain plug, and watches as Manhattan drains away. Yes, she lay beside him gentle, 'cause he told her that he loved her, and he made her dance before the music played. But at least she didn't beg him, she'd rather wash her dishes. It makes her feel as if her hands are clean. Yes, it makes her feel as if her hands are clean.
That's Glenn Campbell. They say he's the seventh son of a seventh son. Glenn, singing about a town a little bit larger, I suppose, than Delight, Arkansas. Actually, the way they sing about that town, it sounds like a little Peyton place. I'm talking about this song, Manhattan, Kansas. Among the new stars making the grade this year, and every year I think presents new faces in country music, Donna Fargo is a young lady who came out of nowhere recently and achieved for herself a number one record. Donna, as we have pointed out before, is an English teacher from Covina, California. And here is that number one record.
Shine on me, sunshine, walk with me, world, it's a skippity doo-da-day. I'm the happiest girl in the whole USA. Good morning, morning, hello, sunshine, wake up, sleepy head, why'd you move that Bojangle clock so far away from the bed? Just one more minute, that's why we moved it. One more hug or two, do you love waking up next to me as much as I love waking up next to you? You make the coffee, I'll make the bed, I'll fix your lunch and you fix mine. Now tell me the truth, do these old shoes look funny? Honey, it's almost nine. Now you be careful, gotta go. I love you, have a beautiful day, and kiss the happiest girl in the whole USA. Skip what it do, thank you, Lord, for making him for me. And thank you for letting life turn out the way that I always thought it could be. Now once was a time when I could not imagine how it would feel to say I'm the happiest girl in the whole USA. Now shine on me, sunshine, rock with me, world, it's a skippity-doo-da-day. I'm the happiest girl in the whole USA. Shine on me, sunshine, rock with me, world, it's a skippity-doo-da-day. I'm the happiest girl in the whole USA.
That's the very clear sound, and I love to hear Donna Fargo sing because I can understand every word she sings. Donna Fargo singing, The Happiest Girl in the Whole USA. You know, it's funny. Some people have got the idea that anything that's good for them can't possibly taste good, too. Well, those people are in for the pleasantest surprise since the discovery of the apple. That surprise is in Buckwheat's High Nutrition Cereal. Buckwheat's not only has what it takes to help you feel fit, it's got a flavor combination like no breakfast cereal ever had before. Brawny buckwheat flavor with a snap of maple in crunchy golden brown flakes. It's good. Yet nutritious buckwheats helps you feel like $1 million, and that's a great feeling.
Feeling like $1 million, and it's great to be alive.
Got a feeling like.
Feeling like $1 million, and it's great to be alive. Buckwheats with a hearty taste. Buckwheat and maple taste, and you're feeling like $1 million, and it's great to be alive.
High nutrition and good taste, all in one great cereal, Buckwheats. Now, Charlie Rich, who's next?
Next on the list is Mr. Ray Price, singing Lonesomest Lonesome.
Well, I scorched your favorite pan this morning trying to make some pancakes. Spilled the grease and had to stop and mop the floor. Sat there like a little baby crying in my cornflakes. I don't think I can take it anymore. Baby, come home. This is the lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Late last night I woke up trembling with my arms wrapped round your pillow and a lump as big as Texas in my throat. Sat there in the dark and played my guitar till the sun came up and wrote the saddest song I ever wrote. Baby, come home. This is the lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. The lonesomest lonesome, oh, the saddest sad, the loneliest I've ever been alone. You were the best thing this poor boy ever had. Now you're gone. Well, tonight I'm gonna get down on my knees and say a prayer for the first time since I can't remember when. And maybe if I'm lucky, when I wake up in the morning, you'll be soft and warm beside me once again. Baby, come home. This is the lonesomest lonesome. Lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Baby, come home.
The words of Mac Davis, the song painter, Ray Price singing The Lonesomest Lonesome. My friends, you're listening to The Ralph Emery Show. Our guest star this week is Charlie Rich. And Charlie, we'll have him back here with his piano in a few minutes. Right now we're going to go to a happy little song by Miss Jeannie C. Riley.
Like a warm and tender kiss in an early morning mist, while the fog hangs on the cane. Good morning, country rain. Good morning, country rain. Good to be back home again. Magic that I can't explain. And a good old country rain.
I have often sat for hours watching rain fall on the flowers. Lord, I hope I never change. Good morning, country rain. Good morning, country rain. Good to be back home again. Magic that I can't explain. And a good old country rain. Many times I think of you and all the changes I went through. It can drive a girl insane. Good morning, country rain. Good morning, country rain. Good to be back home again. Magic that I can't explain. And a good old country rain. I said good morning, country rain. Good to be back home again. Magic that I can't explain. And a good old country rain.
Little old Jeannie C. Riley, the Anson, Texas Flash. Bless her heart. Jeannie C. singing Good Morning Country Rain. Now, my friends, we're going to get back to our guest star, Charlie Rich. Charlie, is there a Charlie Rich fan club?
Not organized.
What do you mean by that?
I have a few fans, but I don't have a fan club.
Well, I know that you have quite a few fans. Fact is, the entertainers, most of them I know, are big Charlie Rich fans. Are you aware of that?
To some degree, and I'm thankful for it.
A lot of them come up and say, I really dig you, Charlie.
Yeah, they do, and it makes me feel good.
Must make you feel very good to be accepted by your peers. Charlie, how about this disorganized fan club? Apparently, then, this is just among people who write to you.
Yes.
How can others write to you if they would like to write to Charlie Rich?
Well, either, through the record company, like Epic Records, or through my management. Well, Memphis, Seymour Rosenberg.
What about if you live in Benton, Arkansas? How big is that?
That's about 15,000 people.
If people wrote just Charlie Rich, Benton, Arkansas, would you get it?
I would get it.
Right. Everybody in town knows who you are?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes that's good, sometimes it's not.
I think it's pretty good in your case, Charlie. We're going to go back a little ways for a song by Charlie Rich called A Woman Left Lonely.
A woman left lonely will soon get tired of waiting, and she'll do crazy things on lonely occasions. A simple conversation with a new man now and then makes a touchy situation when a good thing's coming to an end. And when she gets lonely, she's thinking about her man. He's taking her for granted, and she does not understand. And the fevers of the night, they can burn an unloved woman. The red hot flames
try to push old love aside. Oh, yes, it does. And a woman left lonely is just a victim of her man. He can't keep up his homework, so she does the best she can. A woman left lonely.
That's the sound of our guest star, Charlie Rich. A pretty song and yet kind of sad. A lonely song, but Charlie called A Woman Left Lonely. And now here's Bobby Bond to sing for Chippos.
We're going on a picnic. We're gonna sing some songs. And we're gonna fry the chicken and bring the food along. We're gonna play some baseball and work up an appetite. And we're gonna serve Chippo's potato chips. That'll make the picnic right. And when the picnic's over and the sun is sinking low, we'll end the day with Chippo's sitting by the fire's glow. Chippo's potato chips have better flavor, less oily tasting too. And the foil lined box keeps them fresh even after the picnic's through. Even after the picnic's through.
Chippo's are fashioned from dried potato granules and are flash fried. Get Chippo's, the less oily, better tasting flavor potato chips. Charlie, I believe the next fellow to appear on our show is a fellow you used to work for.
Mr. Chet Atkins, one of my favorite people.
Thank you.
That's Chester Burton Atkins. And I'm sure the tunes you recognized as the Marines Hymn and Anchors Away. Even the Caissons Go Rolling Along is in there, the old field artillery song. Chet with a selection called the Red, White, and Blue Medley. And now, my friends, from the Cookson Hills of Oklahoma, I understand these Cookson Hills used to be the hideouts for various gangsters. Wayne Kemp has told me that story a few times. I think Bonnie and Clyde hid out in the Cookson Hills at one time. Well, that's where Wayne Kemp comes from. Wayne Kemp is a pretty good singer. He wrote a hit one time for Conway Twitty called The Image of Me. Here's Wayne to do his own thing. Wayne Kemp on the show, my friends. Wayne with a great voice. Sounds like he has heard a few George Jones records from time to time. Wayne singing a song simply titled, Darlin'. Now, Charlie, since you're helping me out, you said you were co-hosting the show. Who's next?
Dave Dudley. If it feels good, do it.
I believe in that.
Some folks call me a laughing boy, some say I'm a clown, but till you've tried my way of life, don't ever put it down. And if it feels good, do it. If it hurts, just let it lie. Now there's no mystery to it, just a better way to look at life. Some folks worry about growing old, but that don't bother me. Old age is one thing I hope that I live long enough to see. Forget your disappointments, pretend they wasn't there. But when they pass out happiness, be sure you get your share. And if it feels good, do it. If it hurts, just let it lie. Now there's no mystery to it, just a better way to learn life. One day when I'm old and gray, looking back on what I've done, I can face the world and say that living sure was fun. And if it feels good, do it. If it hurts, just let it lie. Now there's no mystery to it. If it feels good, do it. If it feels good, do it. If it hurts, just let it lie. Now there's no mystery to it.
I sometimes call him Mr. Truck, Charlie. Dave Dudley on our show. Dave singing, If It Feels Good, Do It. You know, sooner or later, there comes a time when you gotta think about staying in good shape. And when that time comes, a little help and encouragement goes a long way. Here's an example.
I'm helping Jim, that's my husband, keep himself fit. He does the exercise, and I give him buckwheats. That's Buckwheat's High Nutrition Cereal. General Mills makes it. And they make it to help you feel like a million bucks. That's what they say, and I believe it. All those vitamins and minerals? Just the kind of nutrition my husband needs to help him get going in the morning. But you gotta be prepared for one thing. Buckwheats really go fast. Something about that buckwheat and maple flavor that Jim just can't get enough of makes it that much easier for me to help him.
Nothing like buckwheats to help a wife, help a husband feel like a million bucks. Buckwheat's High Nutrition Cereal. Why don't you go out and get some today?
Friends, before we close this show, I'd like to sing one more song.
I lost my baby, I almost lost my mind. When I lost my baby, I almost lost my mind. My head's in a spin since you left me behind. I went to see a gypsy and had my fortune read. I went to see a gypsy and had my fortune read. I hung my head in sorrow when she said what she said. I can tell you people, the news was not so good. Well, I can tell you people, the news was not so good. She said your baby left you, but this time she's gone for good. When I lost my baby, I almost lost my mind. When I lost my baby,
hey, I like that, Charlie. Pleasure having you on the show again.
Thank you, Ralph. Nice to be here.
We're going to do it one more time tomorrow.
One more time.
I look forward to it.
Me too.
Charlie Rich on our show with When I Lost My Baby, I Almost Lost My Mind. Tell him bye, Charlie.
Bye, Ralph.
Buckwheat's breakfast cereal and Chippo's potato chips have brought you the show. This is Ralph Emery, thanking you very much for listening. We'll see you again tomorrow at the same time with Charlie Rich as our guest star. Bye-bye.